of dynamic flow, you're gonna do more often. Join your hand in front of your chest. You're standing with your feet hip width apart. All right, you can see that standing tall. However, we don't lean forward, we don't lean backward at the same time. You don't push your body like this. So keep your stomach in and standing long and tall. Inhale, you bring your arms up. Slowly look up to your hands. And exhale, you keep your knees soft. Then you keep your palms down to the floor. Right. Step your right leg back. Right leg straight. Then the moment you step your left back, stay in the plank. So the shoulders above the head. Yes. Knees down, toes down. Without moving your palm, you sit back as much as you can, so your palms glued to the front of the mat. Then inhale, you lean forward. Now have a look. You should feel that your shoulder above the hand first. Yeah, instead of here, shoulder above the hand. Hug the elbows close to your body. Lower your body halfway down. Then you rest the belly and lift your chin, your chest up. Shoulder away from the ears. Yes, from here, we don't want to hurt our back, right? So squeezing more from your butt cheek. Yep, and then tuck the toes. Lift your body up to downward facing dog. Stay here for 3 deep breaths. And now step your right foot forward. Keep the right foot between the hands. Your left leg straight. Yeah. And from here, step your left foot forward. Landing the left foot softly. Keep your feet slightly apart. Now inhale. Keep your hands on your knees. You keep your back straight. So we call this one the halfway lift. So you can check from my back, yeah? Instead of you round the back, so you try to keep your back straight. Exhale, standing forward fold. Then inhale, you bring your arms up, look up. And exhale. So keep your hand at the front of your chest. Good. Let's continue round 2. Inhale, arms up. Exhale down. So hand close to your feet. This time, left leg back first. Keep your left leg straight all the way back. Same. The moment you step your right back, plank. Shoulder above the hand. Nice. Knees down. Toes relaxed. Lean back without moving your palms. Exhale. Then inhale. Leaning forward, shoulder above your hand first. Lower your chest halfway down. Then you're leaning forward. Rest your belly. Squeezing your butt cheek. Engage your inner thigh. And try to lift your body up. Shoulder away from the ears. Tuck your toes. And exhale, downward dog. Nice. So with downward dog, activate your arms, your legs. Look to the space between your feet or look to the back of the mat. Inhale to your nose and exhale. Sigh out. Inhale this time, step your left foot forward, landing your left foot softly. Nice. And now right follow. So keep your feet slightly apart. Halfway lift. So take care of your back. So you come halfway up. Yes, looking straight. Exhale down. Inhale up. And exhale, relax. I'm gonna make things a little harder here. Hey, inhale arms up. And exhale, hands down next to your feet. Right leg back. Good job. The moment left leg back, you keep your left leg out. So we call this one three legs downward dog. Inhale and exhale. Gently place your left foot between your hands. And you shake. Right leg straight, left knee bend. Be aligned with your left ankle joint. And now you come with the high lunge. Inhale. So we're gonna do this for the next 4 rounds. Oh yeah. So do slowly. Keep your palms down. Kick your left leg back. This is inhale. Oh, yes. And exhale, left foot between the hands. Right leg straight. And high lunge. Good, good. Another 3 rounds. Go. Inhale. And exhale. Perfect. 2 to go. One more deep breath, my love. Inhale, three legs, downward dog. Kick your left leg up. Exhale, landing your left foot softly between your hands. Right leg straight, left knee bend, not over your left ankle joint. High lunge. Stay for 3, 2, lengthen your spine. 1, and keep your palms down. Now from here, use only the tip of your finger, all right? I want you to keep your right leg up, bend the right knee, and then you're gonna kick your right leg up towards ceiling. Good, good. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then slowly keep your right foot down. Halfway left. Exhale, standing forward 4. Inhale, arms up. And exhale, hands front of your chest. Inhale, arms up. Look up. Exhale, keep your knees soft, keep your palms down. This time you're gonna step your left back. So keep your left leg back, left leg straight. Are you ready for the other side? So kick your right leg up, three legs, downward dog. And exhale, right foot placed between your hands. So right knee be aligned with your right ankle joint, left leg straight. Inhale, arms up. And now from here, we have 4 rounds to go. So you check, do your best to keep your left leg straight. Only your right knee bend. Keep working on that, yeah? So keep your palms down. We have the other 4 rounds to go. Inhale. And exhale. Yep, check that. Keep your left leg straight. Continue. Three. 2. One more time. And check first, yeah? Left leg straight. We stay here for 3 deep breaths. 3, lengthen your spine. 2, 1. Leaning forward, my love, and use only the tip of your finger. And now, keep your left knee bent. Inhale, exhale. Kick your left leg up towards ceiling. 2, 10 times. 3, yes, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Left foot placed between your hands. Halfway left, keep your back straight, looking straight. Exhale, standing forward 4. Inhale, arms up. And exhale. All right, I'm gonna make things a little harder here. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, down. Right leg back. Left leg up. Now keep your right knee down. So from here, take care of your back. Yeah, this is inhale. Exhale, you're gonna tap your left knee towards to your left triceps. So inhale, you kick. And exhale, left knee to the left tricep. So it's not lower here. Yes, it's happened. So your shoulder above your hands. So inhale, you kick. Exhale. Inhale, kick, exhale, and switch. Come to the other side. So don't move your body, all right? So you can see myself. So you keep your right leg straight. So your right leg back, yes. And now see from here, keep your shoulder, yes, stay steady. Instead of you bend the knee here, I prefer you to say like, ooh, awesome, I can do only this much. I can't touch it, I can't lift higher. That's fine. We're working on that. Yes. How, where you should feel? Feel you squeeze at your waistline. So you squeeze more at your right waistline. 3, 2, 1. Good job. Then stay there. Keep your right leg straight and facing to me. That's why I say that your right leg, but anyway, that's fine. Either way, now your left leg straight. So this is the easier option, okay? You're gonna go to the harder one today. Shoulder above the hand. So this is not above. So make sure you check that, oh, okay, this is what she mean, that shoulder above the hand. Bring that arm up, which leg straight, the arm up, and you squeeze. And then you tap. Up. Exhale, and then you tap. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then you switch the other side. Inhale, again, shoulder above the hand. Do your best to activate all your finger, all right, and squeeze. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now from here, I let you rest first. So have a look what I want you to do. You're gonna be back to downward dog. Don't start yet, yeah, love, just have a look first. You're gonna have the first one here, inhale and exhale. This time it's gonna be harder because first is here, right? So this time your right leg is gonna be straight. Give me 5 times. Then from that, you're gonna give me a side plank and you're gonna work on knee to elbow because at first, this is how we start. Things getting harder when you have less support. All right, so on both sides, let's start from downward facing dog. Get ready. So let's start from the right first. So right leg up. Inhale and exhale. Do your best to keep your left leg straight, right knee towards your right armpit. And then kick. Five. Four. Three. Two. One. Then from here, side plank towards awesome. Left shoulder above the left hand. Right arm up. Inhale here and exhale. Give me one more. Yes, it's not easy. And then you back to downward facing dog. So that is the reason we have an option. So now you know that, oh, I get that the option one and option two. Option two is gonna be a little challenge. So you try the option two maybe one or two times and then you might back to the option one or master the option two and forget the option one. So now left leg up. Inhale and exhale. Left knee towards left armpit. Five. Four. Three. Two. One. Then from here, maybe try only one time or maybe just like awesome, what if I'm gonna try only a side plank. And three. So if you're like, oh, I can do this one. So remember you have an option. Oh yeah. Time to times when we're working with the power yoga, always remember that you need to activate the tip of your 10 finger because many times when people hold in the plank, they put the pressure to their palm. I'm one of those. And when you put only the pressure to your palm, you hurt your wrist joint. So that's the reason why instead of you do like this, when you go to the plank, you need to keep your shoulder slightly above the hand and do your best to activate the tip of your 10 finger. So here, you can start from you leaning forward and back. All right, let's do the foundation here, yeah? So first of all, you come up to all four. Yes, then you check that I pressing the tip of my 10 finger. Inhale, you leaning forward the shoulder above the hand. Yep, and remember that, yes, feel that you pressing the finger down. And exhale, you sit back. Inhale. And exhale, sit back. So remember that when we're working on the spinal imprint, you draw the navel toward your spine, keep the belly in. Whether inhaling here or exhaling here. So in this way, you will not hurt your back and you engage more at your abs. And from that, let's challenge yourself a little bit. You come up to the plank. Inhale, shoulder above the hand and tell yourself, hey, work less at your palm, work more at your 10 finger and exhale, downward facing dog. Good dog. Inhale, exhale, four, Exhale. Three. Exhale. Two. One more time. And exhale. One. Step your left foot forward. And slowly turn towards awesome. Come up. All right. So from here, left toe point straight. Right toe turn to, sorry. Right toe, left toe. I'm the one who confused you right now. So from here, you're going to keep your left knee soft. Left knee be aligned with your left ankle joint. Use the tip of your finger and then you rest your right hand up. Cool. Now I know that because how I wear, I want you to make sure you keep your belly away from the thigh, because what people are doing, they rest their belly on the left thigh, right? So you try to keep your belly away from your left thigh. So this is inhale, exhale. Inhale, keep your left leg straight without locking your left knee. Reverse triangle pose. And keep the left knee soft. Draw the navel toward to your spine so you keep your belly away from the left thigh. So give me another three deep breaths. Inhale. And exhale. Two more. Inhale. And exhale. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Now have a look. You're gonna keep your left foot to the front, right hand by the hip, and lift, whoa, your right leg up. Looking down, belly in, three, two, and one. Extend your right all the way back and come up. Turn to this side. Ha! Huh. You surprised? Yeah, today we work quite hard. Good, good. So from here, right toe turn to the right side. Left toe slightly turn to the right side. Inhale, reverse triangle pose. And exhale, you keep your right knee soft. Belly away from the right thigh. And left arm close to the left ear. Perfect. Another four round. Keep your right knee soft, yeah, without locking. And go. Good. Two. Woohoo, hot, hot. Three, two, to go. Inhale. And exhale. Are you ready? One more here. Inhale. And now, my love, keep your right foot, sorry, right hand to the front, left hand by the hip, and slowly looking down and lift your left leg up. Engaging your core, spinal imprint. Three, two, and one. Extend your left leg all the way and come all the way up. Now turn the toes slightly in. You keep your legs straight. Slowly from here, drag your hands halfway down. Do your best to keep your back straight, all right? Inhale and exhale. Drag your hands down to your mid-chin. Inhale and exhale. Drag your hands down to the ankle joints. Every breath, you're gonna try to lower your body down. Think about you try to lower crown of your head closer and closer to the ground. Weight to the heels, legs straight. So you can feel the stretching at your both hamstring, at your both inner thigh. Slowly from here, hold your left ankle joint with your both hands and stay low. Then you switch, hold another ankle joint with your both hands, then stay low. Then back to the center. Keep your hands be aligned with your feet and look at me. So this is inhale. Good. You're gonna use only the tip of your finger and exhale. You're gonna try to relax your shoulders, elbows, and lower your palms down, lower crown of the head down to the floor. Inhale, halfway up, and exhale down. One more deep breath. Inhale, halfway up, and exhale down. Now, keep the legs open even wider. Turn the toes slightly in. Really feel the stretch at your inner thigh. Three, relax the shoulder. Two, relax the elbow. And one, relax your palm. And now from here, Michael Jackson back. Walk the heels, walk the toe, walk the heel, walk the toe, walk the heel, walk the toe. Until you keep your feet hip width apart, hug the elbows with your both hands, round the spine, draw the navel toward the spine and roll your body up softly and slowly. Good, good. We're back to this one once again. Feet hip width apart. Inhale, lengthen the spine and exhale, lower your body to the left side. Push the hip to the right side. Then you keep your knees bent and round the spine. Circle from left to the right side. Open the chest. Then you start again. Go to the left. Knees bend, round the spine, go to the front. Then go to the right side, open the chest, lean back. One more round. And now we reverse the circle. After this one, the good news, we down to the floor. I was thinking for that. Awesome. Three. I thought you forget about it. One more time. And relax. So sip the water and down to the floor. All right, I'm working on to get rid of the fish smell. Second round. I try to take a deep breath and like, fish smell. It's tough since we're doing Zoom, so you don't feel how I feel. Lucky you. I remember, actually, I'm not the one who cook it. My husband is cook it. I came back from my class outside. So when I came back around 7:15, I smell like something from the moment that the lift is open. And I keep walking to that. What is that smell come from? And the moment that I open my apartment, like, ah, it's from this fucking apartment, my own apartment. It's like, dang. Anyway. All right. Free smell, gone, gone, gone. Okay. From here, let's start from the side line. Remember that last time? Yes, so this time. We're working on wrapping the belly in, yeah? So I'm just gonna show you, you don't need to use the cushion, but when you have, you might feel like, ah, I can see that this is what she meant. Lying to the side, relax your right ear on your right shoulder, yes. Aha, that's good. So, yes, that's good. Inhale, you relax your belly. Exhale, draw the navel toward the spine and you try to wrap the belly in so you feel that there is the space, right? Then inhale, we start over. Exhale, belly in and up. So you know that is two direction. Inhale, you relax the belly. Exhale, squeeze your belly in and up. Now we're gonna work also at the inner thigh while we exhaling. So inhale, you relax. Exhale, belly in and up. Then you squeezing your left knee towards to the cushion. As you're squeezing your inner thigh, inhale, you relax. Exhale, squeeze the inner thigh, belly in and up. Now what I see is, I want you to squeezing the cushion more. Inhale, you relax. And exhale, squeeze, 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 squeeze. Good. So I think this cushion not a good idea. I have to use this. You will definitely gonna see that. Whap! All right. Ready, my love? We're gonna do 5 rounds. Inhale. And exhale. 5. Four. Three. Wrap your belly in and up, pressing your inner thigh down. One more time, inhale and exhale. Good job. Now from here, come to the side plank. So with the side plank, you keep your right shoulder above the right elbow, yeah? And make sure the space from your right elbow to the hip, not too far. Sometimes people keep it too far this way. So make sure that move the hip little closer, yes. Inhale again, exhale, remember wrapping the belly in and up, squeezing your inner thigh and lift your left arm up over the head. You feel like, whoa, awesome. Inhale, you relax. Exhale. Five, four, three, last one, one. Lower the hip down softly. Good job. So from here, they already sipped the water. I forgot. Yeah, I'm just so worried about my studio that smell of fish. So anyway, From here, we're gonna do a little mermaid stretching, then we do the other side, yeah? So keep your right knee bent. Right foot, be aligned with your right shin. Left knee bend and left foot behind, be aligned with your left knee, yeah? Keep your left hand down, lift the right hand up, inhale here. And exhale, right palm down and lift your hip up higher, open the chest, face up, look up. Good job. So give me this for another 4 deep breaths. Inhale and exhale. 4. Three. 2. One more time, inhale and exhale. You know we're gonna hold on, open the chest, stay for 3 deep breaths. 2 and 1. Lower the hip down slowly. So from here, left hand on your right knee, right hand behind the hip, lengthen the spine and give me this twist. Look over your right shoulder and look to the back wall. Stay for 3, 2, 1. And back to the center. Good job. And now we switch to the other side. Same thing here. Lie to the side. Have the cushion between your knees. So, good, good. Boop. And rub, 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 rub. Remember here, inhale, we relax the belly. Exhale, draw the belly inward and upward. Feel the space. At the same time, we're gonna squeezing the inner thigh. This is in one, exhaling. Inhale, relax, and exhale. Now think about belly in and belly up, inner thigh squeeze. Keep your exhaling longer. 4, 3, 2, 1, more deep breath. 1. And slowly come up. So, mini side plank here. Left shoulder above your left elbow and you keep the hip a little closer to the left elbow. Inhale, be ready. And whenever you exhale, wrap your belly in and up, squeezing the inner thigh and lift your right hand up. So inhale. And exhale. 5, 4. So make sure that try to squeeze your inner thigh a little bit more, hey? Do your best to keep the cushion between and really squeeze. Yes. 3, 2, one more time. Stay for 3, 2, squeeze and relax. All right. Okay. Yeah, sometimes that one side, somehow you're gonna feel more than the other side. So keep your left knee bent, left foot be aligned with your left chin and left knee, yeah? And right knee back. Right hand down, inhale, stretch your left arm up, And exhale, left palm down. Lift the hip up, open the chest, face up. Four more deep breaths. Four. Three. Two. Last one. Inhale. And exhale. And slowly lower your body down. Now you're gonna lie down. Oh, before you're lying down, sip the water one more time. That's good. Cool. All right. We come to almost the last part of the session today. You're gonna lie down once again. Get used to lie on the side first and lie on your back. Cool. From here, before we start any spinal imprint, yeah, you're gonna use one cushion, keep one between the knee in case if you feel that you want to prevent the back pain that might happen from this exercise. You might keep another cushion below your buttock. So either way, you can have it or without it, that's fine. Just make sure to lie to the side and then lie to the back. Yeah, I can see that sometimes that how uncomfortable. Yes, so yeah, that's happened. So your heel somehow not too far away, all right, and at the same time not too close to. You just try to adjust the position that you feel comfortable for your shoulder, for your back. Yeah, inhale, you be ready. Exhale, number one, push your belly toward your spine, pressing your butt towards the cushion below your buttock and squeezing your knee toward the cushion that you try to squeezing in. Inhale, you relax. Exhale, belly in, press towards to the cushion and press your knee toward to the cushion as well. And then relax, inhale. So I'm gonna keep my hand like this so you can see my movement. Inhale, relax. Exhale, abs in, butt cheeks, squeeze, inner thigh, squeeze. Inhale, we relax. Basically, we work on the exhaling, yeah, another 5 rounds. 5. Perfect. 4. 3. 2. And 1. Good job. Today you can see that so many exercises, I concentrate more on the inner thigh squeezing, yeah, another muscles that is good to strength. Keep your right foot on the top of your left knee. Keep your hand by the side, palm facing down. Inhale here. Exhale, you try to bring your left knee towards your chest and tap the left foot down to the floor softly and go. 5. 4. 3. 4. So you need to keep the cushion go higher to support the middle back. Yes. So because of you use your pillow, just turn the other way around. Keep in like the horizontal. Right now it's horizontal line. Go with the vertical line. A long line. Yes. And support from your middle back and lower back. Yes. And then from that, when you're done, supposedly you done 5 times. Now from here, bring it up. Right hand between your leg. Left hand outside your left foot and try to pulling your left knee towards you. Good. Stay for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then release slowly. And now we switch. Oh. Okay. Is this from the exercise or is this from carry the baby? Yeah, you can take it off. Just do the one that you feel comfortable. Ah. Okay. Now the other side, yeah? Now left foot on your right knee. The other side. Yeah. Try the other side this time. Your change? Yes. And then keep your right knee toward to your chest and lower your right foot down slowly. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Left hand between your legs and right hand outside your right leg and try to pulling the right knee closer to you. Yes. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then back to the center. So now I think lying down to relax. If it's not the option for you, lie to the side, okay? So when you lie to the side, just relax. Yep. I prefer to this side because I can see you. So you can do next time any side you feel comfortable. My recommendation, when you want to rest to the side, try to keep the cushion between your knees. And totally relax. Keep your eyes closed. Inhale to your nose. Sigh out to your mouth. And once again here, when we relax our body, you just forget spinal imprint, okay? You don't need to work on draw the belly in or whatsoever. Just relax. At the end of your each exhaling, observe that you relax each and every part in your body. Now you relax your eyes. Relax your face. Soften and relax your jaw muscles. Relax your shoulders, relax your arms. Relax your spine from your neck, upper back, middle back, lower back. Chest and belly relaxed. And now you let go the weight of your body down to the ground. Give yourself the permission to sway your body back and forth until you feel the side of your body totally relax on the floor as you let go your weight down. Hips, thighs, knee, all the way down to your calf and your feet, totally relaxed. And let's observe with your inner eyes if there is any particular part in your body you want to pay more attention. Sometimes you might feel so much tension at the back, right? Just like what you said, at your middle back. So when you inhale, think about you sending the oxygen to the part at your middle back. And exhale, just imagine we let go the pain from the middle back down to the ground. Or you might feel the tension around your eyes. So inhale, relax. And exhale, let go the tension from your eyes down to the ground. And let's end the session today by saying the word Om for 3 rounds. Allow the energy when you say the word Om travel from your mouth to your throat, to your heart, to your belly, to your womb, and down out from your birth canal, from your root chakra, down to the earth. Okay, so inhale. Om. Om.